and be just fine. If not today, well, the sun'll come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun'll come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away.
Hey you, little girl.
Yes, officer?
That dog there, ain't I seen him run around this neighborhood? Ain't he a stray?
Stray? Oh no, officer, he's my dog.
Your dog, huh? So what's his name?
His name is Sandy. That's right, Sandy. I call him Sandy because of his nice sandy color.
Sandy color. Okay. Let's see him answer to his name then.
Answer? You mean when I call him?
Right. You call by his name, Sandy.
You see, officer, sometimes he just doesn't want to answer.
Call him!
Okay. Come here, Sandy! Come here, boy! Come here, Sandy! Come here, Sandy! Come here, boy! Good old Sandy!
Well, maybe he is your dog. But the next time I see him, I want him on a leash and with a license. Or else he goes to the pound and pull him to sleep. You understand?
Yes, officer. On a leash and with a license.
I'll get along with you before you catch the death of the cold in this weather.
Oh, I don't mind the weather. When I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun'll come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day away. Tomorrow, tomorrow, I love ya, tomorrow, you're always a day.
I need some more wood for the penthouse.
Hey, Eddie, give me a hand here.
Sure thing, beautiful.
Hey, Sophie, is this junk ready yet?
Patience, patience.
Make way for John D. Rockefeller.
How'd it go today, Alice?
7 million people in this city and you can't sell one lousy apple.
Excuse me, folks. Excuse me. Did anybody here leave a red-headed kid at an orphanage 11 years ago?
No.
Not me, kid.
Ladies and gents, dinner is served.
Hey, kid, you hungry?
Nah.
Okay.
But my dog is!
Here, kid, eat your fill.
Thanks, lady.
Hey, kid, what are you doing out alone at this time of night?
I'm
Lost? How long have you been looking for them?
11 years.
Now that's lost.
Hey, kid. It's time to give up.
No! I'm gonna find them!
Hey, there's something I haven't heard since 1928.
What?
Optimism.
Optimism? What do we gotta be optimistic about? Look at us. Life's a nightmare.
Well, you gotta have a dream.
But traffic, rattling overhead all night.
To wake you up from your nightmare.
Deep pockets.
At least you got pockets.
Freezing fingers.
Lucky you got them empty pockets.
All right.
Newspapers for blankets.
You can read in bed.
Kid, you should have been a politician.
Yeah, you should have run against Roosevelt.
Hey, listen to this. Former President Herbert Hoover said today in an interview, although I was in no way personally responsible for the 1929 stock market crash, I have the deepest sympathy for the millions who are now ragged, hungry, and homeless.
Ragged.
Hungry.
Homeless. Today we're living in a shanty. Today we're scrounging for a meal.
Today I'm stealing coal for fires. Who knew I could steal?
I used to winter in the tropics.
I spent my summers at the shore.
I used to throw away the papers.
He don't anymore. We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover, for really showing us the way. We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover. You made us what we are today. Prosperity was round the corner. A cozy cottage built for two. In this blue heaven that you gave us, yes, we're turning blue. They offered us a Smith and Hoover. We paid attention and we chose. Not only did we pay attention, we paid through the nose.
In every pot he said a chicken.
But Herbert Hoover he forgot. Not only don't we have the chicken,
you ain't got the pot.
Hey Herbie,
you left behind a grateful
nation. So Herb, our hats are off to you.
Herb, our hats are off. We're up to here with admiration.
You think he'd like a little stew?
Come down and share some Christmas dinner.
Ho, ho, ho.
Be sure to bring the Mrs. Stew.
Bring the Mrs. Stew.
We got no turkey for our stuffing. Why don't we stuff you? We'd like to thank you, Herbert Hoover, for really showing us the way. You dirty rat, you bureaucrat, you made us what we are today. Come and get it, Herb.
We'd like to thank you, Herb Hoover.
Evening, officer.
Yeah, evening. All right, move all you bums out of here.
They're not bums.
We're tearing the shrunk pile down now.
Island?
Yeah.
Molly threw up on it before. see them. Little girls, night and day, I eat, sleep, and breathe them. I'm an ordinary woman with feelings. I'd like a man to nibble on my ear, but I'll admit, no man has bit. So how come I'm the mother of the year? Little cheeks, little teeth, everything around me is little. If I ring a little X, surely I would get an acquittal. Some women are dripping with diamonds. Some women are dripping with pearls. Lucky me, lucky me, look at what I'm dripping with. Girls, shut up! How I hate little shoes, little socks, and each little bloomer. Anything that you can do to little girls. Peppa, pick up your kid.
Family. Oh, the big red letters stand for the Jell-O family. That's Jell-O.
Yum, yum,
yum. Jell-O pudding. Yum, yum, yum. Jell-O tap, the Oka pudding just story. Once again, we bring you the romance of Helen Trent, who sets out to prove for herself what so many women long to prove, that because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life need not be over, that romance can live in life at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so. Yeah?
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yeah.
Good. I'm Lieutenant Ward from the 17th Precinct. Drive the runaway. You!
Shh! Annie! Thank you so much, officer. Children, children, guess what?
What?
There's hot cocoa and ginger snaps for you in the recreation room.
What recreation room?
Shh! Shoot, shoot! Thank you so much, officer.
She's in one of them.
Hoover villains, down by the dock, and a mangy mower waiting on the way.
Aw, poor pumpkin. Out in the freezing cold with nothing but that thin sweater. I hope you didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much, officer.
On the line of duty. And you, don't hear that ever run away again from this nice lady.
She's not!
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, officer. Now I'll have your head, and the next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. Well, are you glad to be back? Huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always... you. Never tell a lie. Now, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
For what you've done, I could get fired. Have the Board of Orphans sticking their nose into here. Well, you'll pay for it. I promise. Stay.
Yeah? Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah.
Oh, good. I'm Grace Farrell.
So?
And the New York City Board of Orphans suggested
Wait a minute! I can explain everything. It was Annie Iffy who got into Mr. Bundle's laundry bag and...
Miss Hannigan, I...
And I know I should have called Mr. Donatelli instead of the cops, but...
Miss Hannigan, I'm sorry. But I don't have the slightest idea as to what you're talking about.
Wait a minute. Hold it, sister! If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need any. Get out of here!
Miss Hannigan! I am not peddling anything. I am the private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
Oliver Warbucks? The Oliver Warbucks?
The Oliver Warbucks.
Love the hat. So, I read in Mr. Winchell's column that Oliver Warbucks is the world's richest unmarried man.
I wouldn't know. I don't read Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays with him at his home.
An orphan?
Yes, an orphan.
You sure he wouldn't rather have a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. It's a joke! What sort of orphan did you have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly. And intelligent.
Mississippi. Capital MISSISSIPPI. Mississippi.
And cheerful.